الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, welcome to the blessings of Eid. First of all, Eid Mubarak to all of you. In today's episode of the blessings of Eid, we're going to listen to some of the real important things and stories which will help us make the most of this Eid al-Fitr, inshallah, Savajal. In the beginning, as usual, let's listen to the excellence of Guru Depak. A beggar once begged something from some disbelievers who sent him to Sayyidina Ali Karamallahu Ta'ala Wajhahul Kareem, who was standing there at a short distance away. The disbelievers did so with the intention of ridiculing Sayyidina Ali Karamallahu Ta'ala Wajhahul Kareem. When the beggar asked Sayyidina Ali Karamallahu Ta'ala Wajhahul Kareem to give him something, he radiallahu ta'ala anhu recited Durood Sharif 10 times and blew on the beggar's hand. Then ordering the beggar to close his fist and open it in front of the disbelievers, he radiallahu ta'ala anhu sent him to them. The disbelievers were laughing, expecting nothing to happen. When the beggar opened his fist, it was surprisingly full of gold dinars. Having seen this great miracle, many disbelievers embraced Islam. Sallu ala al-habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, regarding the sanctity of Ramadan, the beloved Rasul of Allah, knower of unseen, faultless, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, its first 10 days are of mercy, the middle 10 days are of forgiveness, and the final 10 days are of freedom from hell. We learn that Ramadan is the month of mercy, forgiveness and freedom from hell. Therefore, we have been given the opportunity to celebrate Eid al-Fitr immediately after departure of this blessed month. Celebrating Eid is a preferable mustahab act. So we should do celebrate the favors and mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal. The Quran also persuades us to rejoice over the bounties and mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal. The 58th verse of Surah Yunus, part 11 says, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل بفضل الله وبرحمته فبذلك فليفرحوا. Translation from Kanzul Iman. Say you, only Allah's grace and only His mercy on it, therefore let them rejoice. Look, when a country gets freedom from the clashes of a cruel government, it celebrates its Independence Day every year on the same day of the same month. Similarly, a student becomes overjoyed when he gets success in his exams. Ramadan is such a blessed and sacred month in which the divine law was revealed in the form of the Holy Quran for the betterment, reformation, well-being and the eternal salvation of the whole humanity. It is the month in which every Muslim's faith is tested. Therefore, having found a perfect code of life in the form of the Quran and succeeded in the tough exam of a month, feeling and expressing happiness is natural for a Muslim. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, Allah Azza wa Jal has bestowed upon us a great favor in the form of Eid al-Fitr immediately after Ramadan. This blessed Eid has many virtues. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma narrates, the auspicious night of Eid al-Fitr is referred to as the Laylatul Jaiza, the night of reward. On the morning of Eid, Allah Azza wa Jal sends His innocent angels to every city, where they stand at the end of every street and call out, O Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, Come to the court of the beneficent Allah Azza wa Jal, who grants in abundance and forgives even the most severe sin. Allah Azza wa Jal then says to His people, O my people, ask for whatever you want. I swear by my honor and glory, I will grant whatever you ask for about your hereafter in this gathering of Eid Salah today. And whatever you want regarding the world, I will look to your betterment. Meaning, I will do what is best for you. I swear by my honor, I will conceal your mistakes so long as you abide my commandments. I swear by my honor, I will not humiliate you with the sinners. So return to your homes as forgiven people. You have pleased me and I am pleased with you. Subhanallah. Subhanallah Azza wa Jal. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, how kind our merciful Allah Azza wa Jal is to us. He showers His mercy upon us in the whole month of Ramadan, and then He Azza wa Jal grants us the happiness of the Eid as soon as this auspicious month ends. According to the foregoing sacred hadith, the night of Eid al-Fitr is also called Laylatul Jaiza, or the night of reward, in which the pious are given their reward. In other words, they are given their Eid gift. SubhanAllah. The King of all the Prophets, the mercy for the whole mankind, the beloved Rasul of Allah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, whosoever stood to offer Salah in the nights of Eid, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha, in order to earn reward, his heart will not die on the day when hearts of people will die. Sayyidina Mu'adh bin Jabal radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, the one spending the following five nights worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal will surely enter the heaven. The nights of the 8th, 9th and 10th Zilhajjah, three nights. The night of Eid al-Fitr and the 15th night of Shaban, Shabe Barat. According to the hadith narrated by Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, on the day of Eid, the innocent angels make announcement about Allah's favors and bounties. Allah Azza wa Jal showers His mercy and blessings upon the people. He Azza wa Jal forgives the people that gather for the Eid Salah. Moreover, it is also announced that whoever desires the goodness of this world and the afterlife should ask for it. His desires will surely be satisfied. With that, we learn what to ask for on such sacred occasions. When the prayers are likely to be answered, usually people ask for the worldly betterment, success, blessing in their sustenance and other worldly benefits only. Along with worldly betterment, we should do ask for the betterment and goodness of our hereafter. Steadfastness of our faith, death in the state of faith in Medina at the feet of the King of Medina sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam in the form of martyrdom, burial in Jannatul Baqi and neighborhood of beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam in Jannatul Firdaus without being held accountable. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, ponder how important the day of Eid al-Fitr is. It is the day of Allah's mercy. No one is disappointed. On one hand, the pious people of Allah Azza wa Jal rejoice over mercy, forgiveness and blessings, while on the other hand, the worst enemy of mankind, Shaitan, burns in the fire of fury when he sees the believers being blessed with Allah Azza wa Jal's huge favors. Sayyidina Wahab radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, the devil screams and cries on the occasion of Eid every year. Seeing him crying, the other devils gather around him and ask, O Master, why are you so furious and disappointed today? He replies, regretfully Allah Azza wa Jal has forgiven the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So make them indulge in satisfying their carnal desires. Did you see that the day of Eid is so tough for the devil that he orders his progeny to make the Muslims indulge in satisfying their carnal desires? Alas, these days the devil seems to have succeeded in his mission. On the day of Eid, we should be thanking Allah by worshipping Him in abundance. But unfortunately, it appears the Muslims have been unaware of the actual concept of Eid al-Fitr. Nowadays, Eid is celebrated by wearing attractive clothes of the latest fashion. And even such clothes bearing the image of living creatures are also put on. It has been stated in Bahari Sharia that offering Salah wearing such clothes that have images of animals or humans is makruh tahrimi. It's close to haram. It is wajib to change such clothes or wear something over them and repeat the Salah. Wearing clothes with images of living creatures is prohibited even when not offering Salah. Bahari Shariat part 3 page number 141 and 142. Further dance parties are held. Different useless and time-wasting fairs and games are arranged in the name of enjoyment. Films and dramas are watched at homes and cinemas. And a lot of time and wealth is wasted on such activities that are in contradiction to Sharia and Sunnah. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, these unlawful actions may turn this blessed Eid into a day of warning for the ungrateful. For the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, have pity on you and give up fashion. Never waste money as Allah Azza wa Jal has declared the spendthrift as the brothers of the devil. Therefore, the 26th and 27th verse of Surah Bani Israel part 15 say, translation, Kanzul Iman, and spend not extravagantly. No doubt, the extravagant are the brothers of the devils, and the devil is very ungrateful to Allah. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, the foregoing verse has made it clear that the Holy Quran strictly condemns the waste of money. Remember, no one can please Allah by wasting money. The distinguishing factor between humans and animals is wisdom, strategy, and far-sightedness. Unlike humans, animals are not concerned about their future, and none of their actions is based on wisdom, which has not naturally been granted to them. On the contrary, humans are concerned about their future, and Muslims are concerned about the hereafter as well. Thus, the one making efforts for the betterment of the hereafter with proper strategies is in fact a wise person. But unfortunately, no effort is made for the betterment of the hereafter, taking advantage of this mortal world. Nowadays, earning wealth, eating excessively, and then sleeping deeply seem to have become the people's aim of life. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, the aim of life is not just to get high degrees, eat, drink, and make merry. Instead, there is a very great and sacred aim of our life. Let's ask the Holy Quran. Oh, the true book of Allah Azza wa Jal, please guide and tell us what the purpose of our life and death is. The Holy Quran answers, translation, Kanzul Iman, He who has created death and life, that He might test you as to whose work is excellent among you. Therefore, the creation of life and death is aimed at testing humans as to who the more obedient and sincere is. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, in order to defend yourself against the attack of shaitan, please spend the sacred moments of Eid in the company of the Prophet's devotees with a Madani kafila. A true story is presented for your persuasion. An Islamic brother belonging to Jhelum stated that his wife became expectant nearly to 6 months after the marriage. The doctor expressed serious concern over the case due to the lack of blood in her body, which might lead to a caesarean and oppression. The Islamic Brother immediately made the intention of traveling with Madani Kafila for 30 days. After a few days, he traveled with the Madani Kafila, acting upon his intention. Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, with the blessings of the Madani Kafila, a baby boy was safely born at his house without any operation. Sallu ala al-Habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, since may well turn the day of Eid into a day of wa'id, warning, which may result in the sinner being punished. Eid is not for the one wearing new clothes. Instead, Eid is for the one fearing the divine retribution. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, there is a world of difference between today's Muslims' way of celebrating Eid and that of our saints. Allah Azza wa Jal forbid these days people regard that Eid is all about wearing new clothes and eating delicious food. Whereas our respected saints would avoid luxuries of the world and would always go against their nafs. Sayyidina Zunnoon Misi rahmatullahi ta'ala had not eaten any delicious thing for 10 years despite his nafs' prolonged desire. He rahmatullahi ta'ala would often turn down his nafs' demand. Once on the sacred night of Eid, his heart suggested him to eat something delicious on the day of Eid, putting his heart on the test. He rahmatullahi ta'ala replied, "First, I will recite the entire Quran in 2 rak'at salah on my heart. If you support me in doing so, then I will eat something delicious tomorrow." Therefore, rahmatullahi ta'ala succeeded in reciting the whole Quran in 2 rak'at salah with concentration on Eid and sent for delicious food afterwards. As he picked up a morsel and was about to eat it, he suddenly became anxious and put it down without eating. Having been asked, he rahmatullahi ta'ala replied, "As I was about to eat the food, my nafs said to me, 'At last I have succeeded in satisfying my 10 years long desire.' Listening to it, I became anxious and replied, 'If it is so, then I will never let you succeed and I will never eat the delicious food.' Meanwhile, a man entered the house along with a tray of delicious food and said, 'I prepared this food last night for me. When I slept, my sleeping fate awoke. I was blessed with the vision of the noble Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam in my dream.' My dear and beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam ordered, 'If you want to see me on the day of judgment as well, then take this food to Zunnoon rahmatullahi ta'ala and say to him, "Have reconciliation with your nafs for a moment and eat a few morsels of this delicious food.'" Listening to beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam's command, Sayyiduna Zunnoon Misri rahmatullahi ta'ala immediately started eating the food, saying emotionally, "I am obedient, I am obedient." May the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal be upon him and may we be forgiven for his sake. Sallu ala al-Habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, did you see the pious people of Allah Azza wa Jal did not follow their nafs even on the day of Eid? They did not care about carnal desires and would always remain satisfied with the will of Allah Azza wa Jal. They avoided the luxuries of this worldly life for the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal and His beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. These fortunate people are specially fed by Allah and His beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. We also learn from this narration that our beloved Rasul, the king of both worlds sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, is aware of the state of his ummah even today. He sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam was watching his beloved servant Sayyidina Zunnoon Misri rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. That's why he sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam sent one of his servants along with food and message for Sayyidina Zunnoon Nisi rahmatullahi ta'ala. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, no doubt having a bath, wearing new or washed clothes and applying itr, pure perfume, on Eid, all are sacred sunnahs whereby we get the purification of our external body. Apart from this external purification and beauty, we should purify and beautify our souls as well with the love and obedience of our dear and beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam and our merciful creator Allah azza wa jal, who loves us more than even our parents. Dear Islamic brothers, please ponder. If somebody disobeyed Allah azza wa jal in Ramadan, instead of worshipping him, missed all the fast, spent the blessed nights partying, playing or watching games such as cricket, table football, video games, reading romantic novels instead of reciting the Holy Quran, listening to songs instead of naat, and messing around the whole month, and then he celebrates Eid by wearing English dress. It is just like covering impurity in silver paper and putting it on display. Oh, lovers of Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, in fact, the fortunate Muslims spending the sacred month of Ramadan fasting, offering salah and doing other worships deserve the celebration of Eid, which is a day of reward for them from Allah azza wa jal. As for us, we should fear Allah azza wa jal, as we could not properly carry out worship even in this sacred month. On the day of Eid, some people came to the house of Sayyidina Umar Farooq Azam radiallahu ta'ala anhu to meet and greet him. But the door was closed and the sound of his crying was emanating from the house. When the door opened, they asked surprisingly, "O Amirul Mu'mineen radiallahu ta'ala anhu, today is Eid and everyone is delighted. Why are you crying?" He radiallahu ta'ala anhu replied, wiping his tears, "O people, this is the day of Eid celebration as well as the day of Wa'id, warning. Indeed, this is Eid for the one whose salah and fast have been accepted. But it is the day of Wa'id, warning for the one whose salah and fast have been rejected and thrown at his face. And I am crying because I do not know whether my worship has been accepted or rejected. May Allah Azza wa Jal have mercy on him and forgive us for his sake. Eid ke din umar ye ro ro kar, Eid ke din umar ye ro ro kar, bole kya bole, bole nekon ki Eid hoti hai, bole nekon ki Eid hoti hai." Allahu Akbar. Ponder. Farooq Azam radiallahu ta'ala anhu is one of the only 10 fortunate beloved Rasuls sallallahu alayhi wasallam companions who were blessed with the glad tidings of entering heaven by the honor of heaven sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam in their life. He radiallahu ta'ala anhu was found crying on the day of Eid just for fear of his worships being rejected. Subhanallah azza wa jal, the one who absolutely deserved the celebration of Eid cried fearfully. On the other hand, we talkative, inactive and negligent people who are unable to carry out any worship properly leave no stone unturned to boast about our so-called piety. Those who unnecessarily reveal their worship such as salah, fast, hajj, service to the masajid and people etc. should particularly take some lesson from this heart-rending story. Such people get the news of their social work published in the newspaper along with even their photograph. Ah, it seems extremely difficult to change their self-liking frame of mind and make them realize that in some cases, unnecessary expression of virtues may result in the ruin of the good deeds and ostentation which may lead to damnation of hell. Remember, having photos willingly taken and published in the newspaper is haram. May Allah Azza wa Jal protect all the Muslims from ostentation, boasting and the harm of our nafs. Ameen bijahi nabil ameen sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. In the end, let's listen to a beautiful kalam written by Amir Ahle Sunnat Damat Barakatuh Min Aliyah.
بعد رمضان عید ہوتی ہے بعد رمضان عید ہوتی ہے بعد رمضان عید ہوتی ہے رب کی رحمت مزید ہوتی ہے رب کی رحمت مزید ہوتی ہے عید تجھ کو مبارک اے صائم عید تجھ کو مبارک اے صائم روزہ داروں کی عید ہوتی ہے روزہ داروں کی عید ہوتی ہے روزہ خوروں خدا کی ناراضی روزہ خوروں خدا کی ناراضی سن لو تم پر شدید ہوتی ہے سن لو تم پر شدید ہوتی ہے عید کے دن عمر یہ رو رو کر عید کے دن عمر یہ رو رو کر بولے نیکوں کی عید ہوتی ہے بولے نیکوں کی عید ہوتی ہے مجھ کو عیدی میں دو بقی آقا مجھ کو عیدی میں دو بقی آقا جانے کب میری عید ہوتی ہے جانے کب میری عید ہوتی ہے عید عطار اس کی ہے جس کو عید عطار اس کی ہے جس کو خواب میں ان کی دید ہوتی ہے بعد رمضان عید ہوتی ہے رب کی رحمت مزید ہوتی ہے
صلو علی الحبیب صلی اللہ تعالی علی محمد صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وآلہ وسلم